do our interview today.
Thank you, Olivia. It's my pleasure.
Could you please introduce yourself and where do you come from and why are you here in Semarang?
Well, my name is Maybe Zingarini from Zimbabwe. I'm here in Semarang as a student, a master's student, 2017-2018, yes.
I heard you from Zimbabwe. Could you please tell me about Zimbabwe?
Well, Zimbabwe is one of the most beautiful African countries. In we call it a place of wonder. Like, if you just set your eyes in Zimbabwe, everything will be just wonders. It's in Southern Africa, yes.
Let me ask you some questions related to your life.
Yes. You're pretty welcome.
What is the highlight of your life so far?
My life actually is in the good direction. Number one, I can say from a religious point of view, everything is well. From an educational point of view, I am somebody who is empowered. I can say I'm a graduate from the University of Zimbabwe. Actually, I graduated twice, and I'm yet to graduate for other degrees. I don't know where I'll obtain them from here.
Let me ask you about maybe a historical person that you want, that you most admire.
On that one, I can say the president of my country, yes, he's called Robert E. Cabral Mugabe, yes. He's one of the historical persons whom I admire.
Why?
It's because of his character, it's because of what he believes in. He's one kind of person who respects people regardless of their backgrounds. Yes.
Let me ask you about your future.
Wow. My future actually is going to be great. Number one, I'm a person who takes opportunities as it is. I don't see challenges, I don't see problems, but I see challenges. And these challenges, they are not permanent. I am the one person who believes in yourself. To be great, it's a matter of having the spirit inside yourself to make a difference, to make a change. So because of that, I'm going to be somebody in life. Yes.
Let's talk about love here. Do you know a couple whose love has lasted through better and worse, richer and poorer in weakness and in health? And could you please tell me about your story?
Well, the question is so broad, but I'm going to try to answer it. I can say my parents are one of the most people whom I admire most because of what they've done to make their love grow. They are now, like, my father is in his 60s, my mom late 50s, but they are still loving each other. And they're doing everything to make their love grow. Number one is communication, number two is respect, number three is commitment and consistency. Yes, you need to tolerate one another. Yes, I think that's all about love here.
Let me tell you, let me ask you about what is the best teacher that you ever had so far?
That question, actually. All right. I believe everyone is a teacher. There's no one person whom I can say this one was the full fountain of knowledge or somebody. I know. But learning is more like it's an endless process. You learn today, you learn tomorrow, you learn the day after tomorrow. So every day, it's a day to learn. And learning from somebody who is young, who is older, everyone is a teacher to me.
Mm.
Yes.
Thank you very much for joining our interview today. That's our interview with maybe from Zimbabwe.
Thank you
very much.